Hey guys, what's up? It's Brian Max. We're having a look at the refreshed and refreshingly refreshed Mazda MX-5 RF. And in fact, I haven't spent a lot of time with the RF. I've driven, obviously, the flying Miata, Habu they call it, with the massive V8 in it. That's my favorite. But I've driven the regular MX-5 and, of course, the Fiat 124, which is somehow similar. But this is my first time spending some real time with the RF, and it's nice to do that because I haven't. And, of course, this has all the updates for 2019. So if you're new to the channel, I'm Brian Max, accomplished racing driver, and what you're going to find on this channel are no-nonsense, straight-up reviews of cars that I enjoy to drive, and this is definitely one of them. So join me as we have a look at the 2019 Mazda MX-5 RF. Of course, Mazda fans are going to ask whether, you know, Mazda has perfected the MX-5, and perhaps they have. I mean, sure, it's not quite perfect, but it's excellent in so many ways, and the updates for 2019 definitely make it a heck of a lot better, and with the added power, of course, it definitely gets out of its way. It's a lot more satisfying to drive, for sure, but the basic platform, the basic MX-5, is so good, and this particular model has the right options, or at least what I think are the right options, and it's a great all-around package. Let's remember that the MX-5 is not just a car. It's a sports car that's been carefully considered by its creators so that everything is in harmony and balance. Even in this RF specification, it's exceptionally light for a modern car at just 2,400 pounds. Since the 2019 model year marks a significant update, it's time for an update to the enthusiast codenames. As such, get used to calling the earlier 4th generation MX-5s the ND1, and these 2019 and later cars are now called the ND2. As you know, the big change, of course, is with the 2-liter engine, and there is finally an adjustable steering column. Finally. There's now a dual-mass flywheel, a slightly shorter final drive ratio, and a new exhaust system just to make it sound a little bit better. Of course, Mazda will gladly tell you that the ND2 makes more power. Officially, the 2-liter makes 26 more horsepower and 3 more pounds of torque. As well, the rev limit has been bumped from 6,800 to 7,500 RPM. That leads me to the question about how it makes this newfound power, so I called the expert, Keith Tanner at Flying Miata, to get the real scoop. If you haven't checked it out yet, do have a look at our review of Flying Miata's ND-V8 conversion. That thing is freaking brilliant, and the link is here and below in the description. Flying Miata's put the new car on the dyno, and the charts reveal something very interesting. The power and torque curves of the ND1 and ND2 are roughly identical, up to 6,000 RPM, with the ND1 having a very slight advantage through the middle of the curve. But above 6,000 RPM, it's all about this newly revised 2-liter. As the ND1 completely falls off at 6,000 RPM, the ND2 keeps making power and torque and carries on past 7,000 RPM due to that increased rev limit. What you've got now is an MX-5 that rewards using the full rev range, and it's so much fun to ring out each gear. By the way, Flying Miata can uncork another 15 horsepower from the ND2 with just a couple of bolt-ons. If that's your thing, give Keith Tanner a call. As I mentioned, running through the gears is a joy. The entire act of shifting is near perfect. The shifter feels great, as does the clutch, and the 2-liter is just super responsive. That, along with pedal placement, makes heel and toe as satisfying as hitting a 300-yard drive. The small adjustment in the steering column helps with seating position, and while I know Mazda doesn't want to add any more weight, there should be a little more reach from that steering column. Speaking of which, it's simply a joy to steer this MX-5. It goes exactly where you want it to be, and you can point it with ridiculous precision. Given that it's a small sports car, the steering and chassis feedback is crystal clear. If you haven't driven the Roadster, the RF is light and lithe, but if you have driven the Roadster, the additional mass is immediately apparent. That's not an issue, though, because the RF is still a relative lightweight. What I don't care for is the wind noise when the roof is open. Air doesn't seem to travel around the roof structure and instead bounces off of it, and that noise increases as your speed does. Still, there's much to be said about an MX-5 coupe, if you will, with the added security of a hard roof. In the end, my preference is for the Roadster, to each his own, as they say.
And as much as it's wonderful dynamically, it's not quite perfect. And I think the one thing I would like is a little more self-centering on the steering. It's just not quite there, and the car's so good, it's hard to complain about this MX-5. Like, it's so good.
As you've seen, this car has the right options, specifically the Brembo brakes, forged wheels, and Recaros with a little bit of Alcantara trim. The Brembo simply enhance braking, giving you confident control with the pedal. Lightweight wheels are always a good thing, particularly on a lightweight sports car like this. And these seats, well, they're perfection here, with excellent support and comfort, and I would drive this setup all across the country.
If there is anything to complain about, especially today with 2019 model year cars hitting the ground, it's this infotainment system. It is woefully antiquated. I don't know if there's an aftermarket solution to get rid of it, but oh, it's just outdated. A few years ago, it might have passed muster, but not anymore. And it doesn't look like the MX-5 is due for CarPlay or Android Auto anytime soon, and that's a little bit disappointing. As much as I love this car, to answer the question, do I love the RF? Well, no, and it's primarily because of the wind noise that the roof generates when the top is open. I'm really not enjoying that. I would just go with a regular Roadster, skip the RF altogether. That's my personal opinion. I do understand people will use this differently than I would, but I would not buy this. The regular Roadster is perfect in my opinion, and it's just a wonderful package now for 2019. Love this thing. So good, so much fun. And even though I look like a giant in this thing, I absolutely love it. So thanks for hanging out with us and having a look at this 2019 Mazda MX-5 RF. Hope you liked this piece. And if you did, be sure to click like, share, and subscribe. And as always, we want to know what you think. So please leave a comment below. And if you really liked what we've done here, feel free to drop some dollars in our Patreon, and the link is here on the screen and below. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you again next time.